Good afternoon, Beefy, my fellow subscribers, and everybody else who stumbles across this humble channel. I hope you're well. It's been 6 months, more or less, since I last did a video. Beefy, we've talked about my situation, and hey, this is about music on vinyl. So, would have been, I don't know, 6 or 7 months. Knock at the door. Open the door with my neighbour. He had a box of records. Said, "Here you are, I've got some more. I've got three boxes of records." I think, and it's none of my business, they were either clearing out or downsizing an elderly relative's house. He knows I like vinyl. He gave me them and says, "There you go, keep what you want, bin the rest." And I thought, bin? So there was probably about 70 to 80 singles and about 60 to 70 LPs. I thought, well, I'll go for the singles first. When I looked inside the box, most didn't have a dust jacket. Some were quite dusty, but it was obvious just looking at them that I think they'd been used as frisbees. Their condition was poor. Just like, that ain't going on my thing. I'm not playing those because they're just, well, they were unplayable. So it was like bin, bin, bin. I came across, probably check out the Twist from 1960 in a dust jacket. I thought, wow, I'm not interested in the value. It's just like a little bit of history here. Took it out of its sleeve, scratched to hell, multiple scratches all over, unplayable. So out of 70 to 80 singles, two. The first one, brilliant. Shalimar, there it is. I still love Shalimar. I can't remember, that was his name, Jeffrey Daniels. I think on British TV, he was the first to do moonwalking, which was a, and body popping, which I'm not going to show you because I can't. But yeah, it's really good. Things like this, and they're covered with, I don't want to be the last to know. Never heard of it, but hey, it's a good song. Not saying a Polydor sleeve, but it's actually on Capitol Records. Get the right way around. A Taste of Honey, Boogie Oogie Oogie. This is a brilliant record, a single from 1978. It plays really well. I still like Taste of Honey. Yeah, brilliant. That's that. There. As with the singles, the 7 inches, well, the 7 inches, a lot of the records weren't in covers, and just again, in a poor state of condition. There's a lot of Rod Stewart, which I don't like. A lot of compilations, this and it's just like, nah. But I did find some real gems. They're all going to be on black vinyl. The real thing. There we go. Four lads from Liverpool. I think on BBC Four there was, I don't know if it's still available, a documentary about them. Basically, they should have done more, but I think one of the guys just got into, I think, drinking drugs and just ruined the band. Just a plain, again, it's good, as you can see, it's shiny. It's got You To Me Out Everything, one of my favourite songs, and Can't Get By Without. I don't know, there's other songs that I just don't know and what they are, but I've played it and it's really good. It really is good. I really like this. Yeah, this is from, I can't tell. Must be somewhere. Don't know, man. On the thing. Have you to everything else? Don't know. Mid to late 70s. What's this one? Oh, yes. This is from, it's a 12-inch single, 45, 1982, Sherry, Murphy's Law. I remember this. That's a really good. I wasn't covered with Anything Is Possible. That's not too bad, but yeah, Murphy's Law, brilliant 12-inch. And this is from 1976 on Contempo Records, Martha Moore, Misty Blue. Now, LP, 1, 2, 5, 10 songs, produced by people I've never heard of. Tommy Couch, James Strood, Wolf Stevenson, Strings and Horns arranged by Wardell. Oh my God, Kazerk. Anyway, I know Misty Blue, that's a single, which I do know, but the rest of it is really good. And again, nice and clean. Really good album. There, oh. A compilation, Black Joy. Lady Marmalade by LaBelle, which I thought that was the original. It's not, I think that's a cover. And then Pink, Little Kid, was it not Little Kid? Maybe Little Kid, Christie Aguilera and Maya did a cover. But I think the LaBelle version is a cover as well. Midnight Train to Georgia, Gladys Not the Pips, that's a brilliant song. A Say a Little Prayer, Aretha Franklin, Stand By Me, Benny King. Yeah, there's the track list. This is really good. Okay, the covers, they're all a bit. And nice clean vinyl. Yeah, a lot of the covers are a bit manky. I'll have to get them. See if I can repair it. But this is a really good song. One of my favourites. Marvin Gaye. How Sweet It Is to Be Loved By You. This is from, I don't know, compilation, oh yeah, the last song is from the 60s, again, just a good compilation, again, all a bit, jacket's a bit knackered, but clean vinyl, it's really good. One of my favourites of the time from the, he had a hit in the 76, 77, but I think his main, Eddie Grant. Yeah, I Don't Wanna Dance, Electric Avenue, it's just really good. I feel like Eddie Grant. This must be from, I don't know, 81, 82, can't see, but this is really good. Yeah, it's a bit, looks like it's been eaten. But it's good. I like it. There. This is probably the 12-inch single, Culture Club Victims. Probably my favourite single. There's not one of the songs that I dislike with a passion. Come a Chameleon. If I'm watching something that comes on, it's change the channel or fast forward through it or whatever. I can't stand this one, but this one is really good. This is from, what's it from? 83, again. Good condition, really good condition actually. A little scuff on it, but not too bad. Next one, Tina Turner Live. This, Live in Europe. This is from, okay, 88. There is, as you can see, David Bowie and Lionel Richie appeared. It is a double album, but the size 1 and 2 just ruined, but size 3 and 4 are really good. Yeah, it's really good recording. Do like a bit of Tina Turner. So what we've got on here? Land of a Thousand Dances. in the midnight hour. Change is gonna come, tearing us apart. Proud Mary, help tonight. Let's dance. That's with David Bowie. It's Only Love with Bryan Adams, not Bush City Limits. Paradise is here again. It was like, oh, this is good. And then the man with the deep voice, Barry White. There's something in there. Look at her, your sweetness is my weakness. Shalala means I love you. September, when I first met you, it's only love doing its thing. Which I didn't realise that's Simply Red covered. Just the Way You Are. Brilliant. Early years, 1978. Produced and arranged by Barry White. This is really good. Wow. The thing with these, again, thick vinyl. Yeah. Good condition. Few little scratches up, but they don't make it. They're just very surface scratches. The production on these is brilliant. It's, I think, because it's all analog. There's no digital in it at all, and you don't get that harshness that you get with CDs. But also, on when something's been recorded electronically and it gets onto record, you can still hear that digitalness. This is just soulful and mellow. It's brilliant. And then, my guilty pleasure. I know they're singles. I think everyone else does. A quick, for a later video, I'll do it at the weekend. Have a gold. My guilty pleasure, ABBA, The Visitors. Never heard of this. There's that cover. This is from 81. The Visitors, Head Over Heels, I know. When All Is Said and Does, Soldiers, I Let Music Speak, One of Us, I know. Two for the Price of One, Slipping Through My Fingers, Like an Angel Passing Through My Room. I recently, because of their success, get on YouTube, there's interviews with the band members, mainly Benny and Bjorn. Benny wrote the music, Bjorn, who is Benny, Bjorn, and the girls, and yet, and Anifrid. They write the songs, give the lyrics, they call them the girls, and they just sing them superbly. And kind of knowing that, listening to this, it's like, yeah, it's a good album, actually. I mean, most people know, I think their biggest was Arrival with Mamma Mia and Dancing Queen on. Villez-vous was like 78, 79. Was Super Trooper an album, just a single? I don't know. Anyway, The Visitors, it's really good. And I'll get with it, that's what I was going to say. Because it's from them. Just a little insert. ABBA offers from their fan club. I'm tempted to photocopy this and wipe the address, see if there's anything there. But you could buy an ABBA t-shirt for the princely sum of £4.50, including postage and package, or a sweatshirt for £8.50. Or an ABBA bag for £7.50. Look at that. That's brilliant. Love it.